Part of what made Minecraft so successful over all of these years is the modding community. There are countless mods for you to use and completely rework the way the game works for you, and there are more and more coming out every single day. Despite the fact that it's only March right now, there have already been a ton of amazing Minecraft mods released, and this video is going to be dedicated to the best of that bunch so far. What is up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos, welcome to Chaos Top 10s, and tonight, we're going to be taking a look at the best Minecraft mods released so far in 2018. So let's get started. This month's giveaway is for a new PlayStation 4 console. All you have to do to enter is drop a like on this video, be subscribed to the channel, and turn on your notifications so you never miss an upload. And in the comment section, let me know why you want to win the PS4 and include your Twitter handle so I can contact you if you're the winner. The winner will be announced at the end of the month. Kicking off our list is a collection of mods that give you a ton of new areas to explore and mine in. It's called the Lost Cities. Now, the Lost Cities is a great name for this mod, as it's a very apocalyptic style area full of strange cities and eerie atmosphere for you to try to survive in. There are tall buildings, there's tunnels, there are bridges, and there are tons of hidden items, loot, and spawners, essentially turning your Minecraft game into a blocky rendition of The Last of Us or The Division. If you're a fan of post-apocalyptic games set in deserted cities, definitely give the Lost Cities mod a try. I'm telling you, it's not going to disappoint. At number 9, we have Mobs Properties Randomness. This mod is for all of you that are looking to make Minecraft a little more exciting and a little more unpredictable. Minecraft has had a decent amount of AI-controlled enemies that will spawn at certain times and try to mess with you, but once you've played for a while, you know exactly how to handle all of them, and they kind of lose their effect. They're not really scary anymore. This is where the Mobs Properties Randomness mod comes into effect. This mod is specifically designed to make all of the enemies more unpredictable and harder to deal with, adding more tension and weight to the mobs you'll encounter throughout your sessions. Now, with this mod, you can adjust the enemy spawns and stats to whatever you want, or just make them totally random to make the game more exciting and put more pressure on yourself to actually survive. So if you think Minecraft is getting a little boring or a little stale for your liking, and you want to turn up the action lever a little bit, check out the Mobs Properties Randomness mod. At number 8, we have Extended Days. If you've played Minecraft at all, which most of you probably have, you know about the day-night cycle that it uses for the gameplay. Certain features on the map will be available or more prominent during certain times of the day compared to others, and the game will continuously loop between the day and the night just to keep your session going, honestly. Well, if you're someone who wants to get a little more time of either the day or nights, check out the Extended Days mod. This mod will do exactly what the title suggests and more, as you will have additional time added to both the days and the nights, allowing you more time to take advantage of them and do whatever it is you want to do that's specific to that time of day you're playing. It's a very simple mod that has a very big impact on the game itself. At number 7, we have Minecraft Discs. Are you someone who likes to listen to music or podcasts while playing video games? In the comment section, let me know, what is your favorite song to listen to while you're playing a game? Whether it's a first-person shooter, whether it's Minecraft, whether it's a racing game, what music gets you in the zone to play your video games? You guys let me know in the comment section. A lot of people love doing it, and since Minecraft is a relatively quiet game, it seems only natural to try and fill that audio void with something, and we've got something. It's the Minecraft Disc mod, where that will come in super handy. With the Minecraft Disc mod, you actually rip the audio of any YouTube video into a little in-game disc, which you can then play in your Minecraft world. Essentially, this is a way to cut out the middleman of putting on some music or podcast in the background of your game, while also adding the novelty of having a little in-game music library for your Minecraft world. At number 6, we have Inventory Tweaks. A very annoying aspect of Minecraft is when your tools break. It forces you to go find some new ones or just to make them all over again. While this may be a very important component to the gameplay, it can get a little annoying from time to time when you just want to keep using the tools and they just keep breaking. With the Inventory Tweaks mod, you don't have to worry about broken tools ever again. By using this mod, you can just go to your inventory and click a button and poof, voila. All the tools in your chest will be fixed, and you can keep using them however much you want without the fear of them needing to be fixed or replaced in the future. It's basically God mode for your tools. Some people like the fact that tools break, as it makes the game more about survival and resource management, and I get that. That's totally fair. But if you're someone who would rather not worry about those tedious little things, check out the Inventory Tweaks mod. cracking to the top five. When I first read about this next mod, the title of this mod, my mind went racing. I was like, holy crap, you can actually like turn animals into bikes in Minecraft, but that's not the case. I'm talking about the Animal Bikes mod. I was a little upset, but it is still a cool mod. So the Animal Bikes mod essentially makes all the animals on the game's map rideable. It allows you to traverse the map quicker while also adding tons of new possibilities for gameplay, since you can instantly tame and ride any animal that you see to your little heart just desires. Any animal. So while you can't actually turn the animals into bikes, which would be way cooler to have a pig with like off-road wheels, this is basically the next best thing. It's a pretty cool mod. It's a pretty simple one, but it also comes in handy. At number four, we have Fast Craft, and this is a mod that is more for helpfulness and functionality than fun or style, but it is still definitely worth a shout due to how effective it actually is. While Minecraft isn't exactly a technically demanding game to play on the PC, it can still struggle on some older computers. This is where Fast Craft comes in handy. Fast Craft is a mod that will rework the textures in the game and make them a little easier on your computer speed, which will allow you to run the game more like normal without having to worry about your older computer struggling with it. So, if you want to play Minecraft on an older or slower computer, which a lot of people have, and you've been struggling with it, check out the Fast Craft mod because it's going to make you feel like you're playing on a precision, well, not exactly. It's going to be easier, okay? It's going to take more load off of your PC in order to operate it. Give it a try. Speaking of making things move a little faster, at number three, let's talk about the Smart Moving mod, and this is all about making the game feel smoother and more natural to move around it. While the Smart Moving mod will keep the world and graphics the same, what it does, it actually alters the way your character interacts with everything, and it will essentially make all the interactive movements happen instantly without you needing to do them directly. This makes climbing, swimming, crawling, etc. far more natural and smooth than it is in the base game, and it also allows you to do these actions on surfaces that you previously couldn't do in the vanilla game. So not only does the Smart Moving mod make the movement smoother, it also makes the world more interactive for you to run around in. It is definitely, definitely worth checking out. At number two, we have Wayla, and this strange name is actually an acronym for What Am I Looking At? This is a mod that will add a new component to your heads-up display during gameplay that will automatically identify any unknown items that you may come across during your Minecraft session. The Wayla mod is great for new players, players hunting for new materials, or just people who like having a more detailed HUD while they're playing the game. And it never hurts to have more information about the world that you're exploring be fed to you while you're playing a game like Minecraft. And Wayla definitely does the job here. And this is really good for new people too. People that have never played the game and they don't recognize what is what. This mod is going to help you pinpoint exactly what's going on in front of you, what it actually is, what the name of it is, and it's helpful. It's super helpful, especially to beginner players. And finally, old and removed features. Like any other game that has been around for as long as Minecraft has, plenty of things have been altered, adjusted, or straight up removed from the game over the years. This is only natural given the fact that Minecraft has been on the market for close to 9 years now, but it's still a shame to see certain aspects leave the game. This is where the old and removed features mod is going to be your best friend. Just as the name suggests, this mod will give you access to any and all features that have been removed from the game, meaning you old school fans will be able to revisit some of your favorite deleted features, and you newer Minecraft fans will be able to go experience the things that were taken out before you picked up the game. Everything in this mod is still functionally and adds tons of new ways to play. The mod is still pretty early in the development, so not everything that has been removed has been added yet, but they are slowly but surely getting everything in there. So if you're looking to play with older features again that you never knew existed, and you're a newer player who wants to experience what Minecraft used to be in the vanilla stages, you should definitely check out the old and removed features mod. In any game you play, Minecraft, World of Warcraft, there's just stuff that you don't get to experience because you came in later, and mods like this make it possible. So soak up all that nostalgic feel from vanilla Minecraft. And there you have it, my friends. Those are 10 of the best Minecraft mods in 2018 so far. Now, obviously, we will get tons and tons more as the year goes on. So if you want me to do an updated video in the future, I will. I did a Minecraft video not too long ago, and you guys really showed a lot of support. So if you want to see more list videos for Minecraft, let me know. We can do texture packs. We can do whatever you guys want. Let me know in the comment section. As always, there is a playlist below. If you just want to go binge watch a bunch of top 10s that are gaming, go check it out. Drop a like on your way out, and I'll see you guys tomorrow night.